This video is a continuation of the discussion of the Konica Minolta based print controller options. The particular driver we are using in this case is the AccurioPress 6120 print controller. This information is also applicable to the IC605 controller for the AccurioPress color presses. You can see that I have come to the workflow section of the driver. The first item available to select is Tandem Mode. Tandem Mode is available only on the black and white presses, and it is available only if you have two machines in the same configuration and the machines have been configured to operate in Tandem Mode. In that case, you can put a check in this box and it will send the job to both machines to be split and run across the two engines. Since I don't have two machines in the same configuration, mine is not configured to do this, so I will not be illustrating this operation. The next section in the workflow tab is send an email. The first requirement for sending an email is that the print controller has to be configured with the appropriate information to access your email server and authenticate and send email from the machine. If your machine is properly configured, you can select to have an email sent to an email address if the file errors out, or to send an email with whatever result is appropriate. And all you would need to do is put in an email address that you would like that email to go to. For print mode, the normal selection is just going to send the job over to the machine. It is going to print normally. Proof mode is going to send a job over, run one set of that job, and then pause at the machine for the operator to inspect the job and determine whether it is correct or not, and then release that job from the machine. Proof first sheet is going to send the first sheet of the job out to the exit so that the operator can inspect it and release the rest of the job if it is correct. Selecting wait is going to send the job to the machine. The machine will pause and display a screen on the operator control panel, allowing the operator to check the configuration of the job and make any changes as required and release the job from there. This is what the operator panel will look like on the machine when a job is sent over to wait. You will see that we are on the machine tab and the job ticket information from the print driver is displayed on the screen along with the thumbnail of the job, and you have the options here to place that job on hold, to run a proof of it, proof the first sheet again, or you can just close out and have that job start printing. Once you press the close button, the machine will return to the normal machine screen, and as it says, you can press start to start printing that job. The next option in the print mode is spool. Spool provided functionality on older versions of the Konica Minolta based controllers. On the current models of controllers available on the AccurioPress, this function is no longer supported. The next section on the workflow tab is output method. Default on most machines is directly to print, in which case the job will go to the machine and print. You also have an option to print and hold, in which case the job will be printed and a copy of the job will be left in the hold queue for reprinting at a later time. You've got an option just to hold, in which case the job will not be printed. It will go to the hold queue and it can be released either through the web browser or directly at the machine by the operator. And you have an option to send the job to hold without ripping the job. The next option is to print and store on the hard disk drive. The hard disk drive operates similar to the hold function, except that when stored on the hard drive, you have the option to create separate folders with logins and passwords if that is a requirement in your environment. The next option we will look at is store on hard drive. Store on hard drive will store on the machine's hard drive in a folder structure and can be released and accessed at the machine. If I select stored hard drive, then I have the options to put in the folder name that I want it to go into, the password to access that folder, And if there are subfolders inside of that user folder, I can tell it which subfolder I would like it to go into. So in this case, I will say that I want to go to user number one's folder. I'll put the password in and confirm the password, and I will put in folder 2 as the box inside of that folder that I would like that job to go to, and I will release that job to print. Returning back to the machine control panel, if we want to access that job we have sent to store on hard drive, we will use the recall button. When we open up the recall section, we will see the folders that are available in there. Remember, we sent to user number one. When I select user number one, it will ask for my password. Enter in my password and click OK. And it shows me the folders that have been created inside of that. As you recall, we sent to folder number two, and we can see that our file is sent and stored in folder number two under user number one in the recall section of jobs stored to the hard drive. In order for jobs to be sent using the print driver to store onto the hard drive, a location has to exist on the machine for it to receive that. It will not create that on the fly. From the root directory, we will use the new button. And on the new button, we would just need to give it a folder name. So we would enter in our folder name, and then we need to assign a password to that. And once we have that password assigned, we can create the folder for user 2. And when we come back up now to the root directory, we'll see that we have a folder for user 2. It's not required that you put a password on those folders. They could be available without a password as well. Returning once again to our print driver and the workflow button, the next option under output method is secure print. When I use secure print, I will assign a name for the secure print and put a password with it. For the secure print ID, you will notice that I've got 8 characters entered here. That is the limit for the ID, as well as the password is 8 characters. So I'll use user 0001, and I don't need that long of a password for this purpose, so I'm just going to enter a short password. I've also got the option to attach a file name to this. So if I enter a file name into this box, that is the name that is going to be stored within secure print. If I do not put any information in this, it will just use the file name. Turning again to the control panel display at the machine, I want to release my secure print job, so I will go to the job list. Under job list, I have an option to select for secure job. Once I bring up secure job, it sees that it created user 0001. Unlike the store to hard drive option, I do not have to have a user already set up here. It will create this based on the information I place in the job. Once I select this, it will ask for my password. I enter in my password and click OK. And it shows me my job so that I can release it from here. I could also select this job from here, look at the job ticket if I needed to, just to confirm that it was set up properly for what I wanted it to do, and change any settings that needed to be changed. The other options that I've got here are to output a sample so that I could take a look at it and make sure that I had it properly set up. I can cancel any settings that I made in this screen. I can store this as a new job, or I can overwrite the existing job. Once I have made the selections that I want to make, I'll click the output button. It will ask me once again how many sets that I want to print, so that if I had only sent over one but I wanted to print 50, I could change my quantity here for 50. I could also proof the entire job and proof the first sheet of the job if I wanted to confirm what it looked like before releasing those jobs, and I can send it to wait which functions similar to the weight we discussed earlier, where the machine screen turns into another screen where you can reset the job parameters if you want to. Once I send that job to print, it disappears from the secure print queue. This brings us to our last topic of discussion on the workflow section, and that is an option that can appear underneath of the file name here for a transmission destination. The transmission destination allows you to have print jobs stored in SMB file share locations external to the controller. So the job would print normally, but a copy of that job would be stored on a file share somewhere else on the network. In order to enable this file storage, we first need to set it up in the controller and then set up a destination for it. So to begin with, I would go into Utility Counter. And once in Utility Counter, I would go to Administrator Settings, press the controller button at the bottom, open the software switch setting, and enter switch 137. Once I have 137 entered into the numerical slot, I will turn that option on and return back out. Now if I enter into the controller section by pressing the button at the bottom, you will see that a new button shows up for file transmission setting. When I open this up, I have 10 destinations that are available to be set up. I've got information entered into destination number 1, so this is going to a file share at this IP address. The path that is shared on that is called share. I've got credentials to authenticate into that share, and I have told this that it wants to store this file as a PDF. The package PDF means the entire job will be stored as a single PDF, and then I get an option for what I want the resolution for that to be when it is stored. I can also store that as a TIFF image, and once again I've got the option for divided or package. Divided in this case will mean each individual page will be stored as a separate TIFF. Returning back to the workflow section in the driver, you'll see that I do not yet have a new option displayed. I need to go into the Configure button, Acquire Device Information, returning back to the Workflow button. I now have File Transmission Setting, and I can choose my destination. When I choose that destination and print the file, looking now on the Network Share, you'll see that my file has shown up here as a PDF file. I also have several files in here that are TIFF images, and these are files that have been stored from a different destination that had files saved as single page TIFFs, and you can see what those TIFF files look like.